Hello, and welcome back to Accounting Stuff. I'm James, and in this video, I'll show you six profitability ratios you should know. We'll calculate each one using a company I made up called Edison, which designs and manufactures electric cars. So without further ado, let's do this. The first profitability ratio you should know is return on assets. Return on assets, or ROA, is equal to a business's net profit divided by its total assets. To calculate it, we need two financial statements, the income statement and the balance sheet. We can find net profit on the income statement. This income statement summarizes Edison's revenues and expenses over a financial year. Net profit is on the bottom line. It's the profit left over after deducting all business expenses. For the year ended December 31st, Edison generated $10 billion in net profit. So let's pop that into our return on assets calculation. Total assets live in the balance sheet. The balance sheet gives us a snapshot of a business's assets, liabilities, and equity at a point in time. Edison's assets are on the left side of the balance sheet. This is a breakdown of the stuff that they own on December 31st. We can find total assets here, $80 billion. So we can work out Edison's return on assets by dividing their net profit of $10 billion by their total assets of $80 billion, which comes to 12.5%. Return on assets tells us how efficiently a business uses its assets to generate a profit. And as you might expect, the higher the percentage, the better. ROA can be improved by increasing net profit relative to total assets. At number two, we have return on equity. Return on equity, or ROE, equals net profit divided by total equity. What is Edison's return on equity? Well, we know Edison's net profit is on its income statement, and it hasn't changed. They generated $10 billion in net profit. We can find their total equity in the balance sheet. This time we look to the right side of the balance sheet, which tells us what Edison owes at a point in time. Liabilities are the stuff that they owe to third parties, and on the bottom right, we can see equity. This is the stuff that Edison owes to its owners. Their total equity is $50 billion. So Edison's return on equity is $10 billion of net profit divided by $50 billion in total equity, which is 20%. Again, the higher the better, because owners want to maximize their return on the money they invested into the business. But watch out! A high return on equity could mean that the business is highly leveraged, which comes with a financial risk. The third profitability ratio you should know is return on capital employed, or ROCE, R-O-C-E. We can work out return on capital employed by dividing operating profit by capital employed. We can find Edison's operating profit on its income statement. It's a couple of rungs above net profit and excludes interest and tax expenses. For this reason, operating profit is often called EBIT, or earnings before interest and tax. Edison's operating profit, or EBIT, is $13.6 billion. So let's place this at the top of our calculation. Now, what is capital employed? Capital employed is the money injected into a business. It's made up of owner's equity and long-term debt. We can calculate capital employed by taking total assets minus current liabilities. Both of these numbers can be found on the balance sheet. Edison's total assets at the end of the year are $80 billion, and their current liabilities, or short-term liabilities, are $17.5 billion. So, Edison's capital employed is $80 billion less $17.5 billion, which is $62.5 billion. This is the capital invested into the business. Now that we have our numbers, we can work out Edison's return on capital employed. $13.6 billion divided by $62.5 billion, which is 21.76%. A high ROCE is a good thing. It tells us that a business is using its capital efficiently to generate profit. Return on assets, return on equity, and return on capital employed are all return ratios. The next three are a little bit different. By the way, I've put together cheat sheets and question answer packs covering all of these financial ratios. You can find them on my website. The link is in the description.
Onward to number four,
net profit margin. Net profit margin is equal to net profit divided by revenue. This is our first margin ratio. Margin ratios are nice and simple because we can get all of our numbers from the income statement. We can find Edison's revenue for the year on the top line, $80 billion. This is the total income Edison earned from selling electric cars before deducting any expenses. By now, I'm sure you know where to find net profit, on the bottom line, $10 billion. It's the profit left over after deducting all business costs. If we take Edison's net profit of $10 billion and divide it by their revenue of $80 billion, then we can calculate their net profit margin. It's 12.5%. Net profit margin tells us how much bottom line profit a business is able to keep for each dollar of revenue earned. In Edison's case, it's 12.5 cents on the dollar. Net profit margin gives us an overall view of a business's profitability because it considers all financial aspects, including cost of sales, operating expenses, and non-operating expenses like interest and tax. At number five, we have operating profit margin, OPM, which is equal to a business's operating profit divided by its revenue. We saw where to get both of these numbers already. We used operating profits to calculate return on capital employed, and we used revenue to work out net profit margin. Both are on the income statement. Edison's revenue is $80 billion, and their operating profit is $13.6 billion. Remember, operating profit is also called earnings before interest and taxes because it ignores non-operating costs like interest and taxes. When we divide operating profit of $13.6 billion by revenue of $80 billion, we get Edison's operating profit margin, which is 17%. Operating profit margin narrows the scope from net profit margin. It focuses on the operational efficiency of a business by considering cost of sales, research and development, marketing and admin costs. It ignores interest, which makes it good for comparing businesses with different capital structures. And it ignores taxes, which is helpful for comparing businesses in different tax jurisdictions, like different states or countries. The sixth profitability ratio you should know is gross profit margin. Gross profit margin is equal to gross profit divided by revenue. So join me once more as we jump into Edison's income statement. At the top, we can see Edison's revenue of $80 billion. And if we work our way down ever so slightly, we deduct cost of sales to reach gross profit. In this context, gross doesn't mean disgusting. It means gross, which is French for big. So gross profit is the big profit at the top of the income statement, and it's $20 billion. If we divide that by their revenue of $80 billion, then we can find Edison's gross profit margin, which is 25%. Gross profit margin restricts our view even further than operating profit margin. Only considers the direct cost of sales. Gross profit margin can be improved by increasing sales prices or reducing the cost of production or changing the sales mix to higher margin products. So here are our six profitability ratios. At the top, we have our three return ratios. They measure a business's ability to generate profit from its assets, equity, and capital employed. And at the bottom, we have the three margin ratios, which compare gross, operating, and net profit against a business's total revenue. A big thanks to all of my wonderful channel members for your support and encouragement. It means a lot. Please let me know what you'd like to see next time down in the comments, and I'll see you then. Au revoir.